بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى اما بعد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في الكلام المجيد والفرقان الحميد بعد اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وليعفوا وليصفحوا الا تحبون ان يغفر الله لكم ايضا قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تغضب صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم وصلي عليه رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقده من لساني يفقهوا قولي ربي زدني علما سبحانك لا علم لنا الا ما علمتنا انك انت العليم الحكيم My most honorable brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we are starting very, very important topic, which is a common disease, spiritual disease also. And it has very, very severe, bad result if the person has this spiritual disease. They are talking about the anger. The topic, anger management, inshallah, it will go in three parts. Today we cover the first part about the anger. Gussa. And the opposite of this is a cool-minded person. Coolness. Peaceful. I quoted Ayat-e Mubarakah before you, the simple mafhum of that meaning. This Ayat-e Mubarakah from Surah Ali Imran, 134. Allazina yunfiquna. Those people who spend in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fits a rai with the rai. When they are well off, or when they are pauper or poor, openly, secretly, when they are well off and poor even, in both conditions, under pleasant financial condition, or under unpleasant financial condition, they spend in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, help the needy people. Well, kaadameen al-ghay. And second, good qualification. Allah is telling, well, kaadameen al-ghay. Who swallow their anger? Somebody bother them? Make them angry? They swallow the anger. Well, afeen al-nas. And they forgive the people. والله يحب المحسنين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those people who offer of highest character and high level of good conduct. Muhsineen. These three good qualities a person has, he will be considered under Muhsineen, and Allah loves those people who have these three qualities. Then Hadith Pak quoted, Prophet said, forgive the people, take it easy. Wa yafu wa yasfahu la tuhibbu. Don't you love it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives you? When you make him angry, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives you. Of course, we love it. The second hadith pak, one sahabi came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ya Rasulullah, would you please give me one nasiha, not long, not too many, and if I follow that nasiha, so Allah subhanahu may save, Allah will save me from, or I should be saved from 1,000 sins, 1,000 wrongdoings. But I want only one advice. Not long. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had very good command on the language, janmir kalam, kalam, mashallah. Prophet said, only two words. La tazab. Don't get angry. Again he said, La tazab. Don't get angry. La tazab. Don't get angry. If we swallow our anger, we don't get angry, we will be saved from 1,000 sins that we commit. Allah Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us, the human being, the emotions. Among those emotions, the emotion is of anger. And it depends upon the condition we are facing. If condition unpleasant to me, of course, I get angry. If I'm very, very pleasant, I remain cool. It depends on the situation. But let me tell you, Allah's mother bless us with two special things. One, intense desire, shahwat. And second, emotion of anger, emotion of intense desire. And second emotion is anger. Both have benefit and both have disadvantage also, harms also. If we use these with moderation, the shahs under control, it will benefit us. For example, If shahwat under control, we get married. You benefit the marriage. We got beautiful children. MashaAllah. And on the other hand, if we don't have control on our sexual desires, then what will happen? And we are not married. We may commit zina. Dangerous. The same way, anger. If the control, it will help us to save our honor, save our body, save our property, save the honor of the wife. It will help us. But if we go out of control, the anger, then we hurt somebody, we could kill somebody, ending up in the jail, this can happen. So, moderation of every kind of emotion is pleasant with good results. So, this is benefit as a danger, but if we bring under normal condition, shahwat is under control, our desires are under control, and our anger under control, it will be beneficial and we need it. What happens? Under unpleasant condition, a special hormone in the body, they are created, they are in the body pop up, special hormones. And which they make our BP, blood pressure high, which our sugar go up, and the blood, instead of remaining in the digestion system, it go to the mind. As a result of that, we are angry, our face become red. So, we have to understand which is best anger, which level of anger is the best, good for us, which is not. This is a big blessing. In reality, controlled anger, supervised anger is a big ni'mat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, if we don't have anger, then what will happen? We cannot save our property and our honor. It's not, we are not Christian. In Christianity, this is advice, if somebody slap on your one side of the face, offer other side. Forgive. But this is not Islam. In Islam, no. We have to save our honor. What is desire? The desire anger is controlled, moderate anger. The anger is under our control. In the beginning, but what is the situation, the ahval, the condition, it go up and down. There are three situations of the anger. Number one, if anger comes very fast and go very late, if anger comes very fast, person becomes angry very fast, and he keeps anger for days and days, this is a disease. Or anger comes very late and finish very late. This is also a disease. What is the best length anger? The best mode of anger, it should come late and go away early. This is the asana, this is the best, this is the moderate. Person does not get angry very fast and he gets rid of anger very fast. Again, deer se aaye aur jaldi chala jaye. Ye ahasan hai, etdaal ke saath hai. Now, what are the signs the person is angry? The person raised, who person is angry, he raised his voice. He looks strange that he's ready to attack. The person angry, he grinds the teeth. He perspires sometimes. Face becomes red. He feels that needle pricking in his body. These are the main signs the person is very angry. We should be watchful. Why people get angry? What is the reason? What is the asbab that people get angry? Number one, unpleasant condition. Number two, the person has spiritual disease of pride, kibar. Arrogant person become angry fast. The person, jealous person, become angry fast. And the person who has a grudge in the heart, the grudge will make you angry. You have enmity against somebody. When you see that person become angry. Love of the wealth. When you lose little wealth, you get angry. Why does a person get angry fast? Too much love for the dunya. It's one of the main reasons also to make you angry. High position. Some people very high position, they get angry fast on their employees. Rich people get angry fast on the poor people. And to a sex desire, if it is not fulfilled, the person gets angry. Person get tired. Person get tired. Of tiredness, you will get angry early, first, fast. If person don't get full sleep, he will get angry fast. Somebody cut joke of you, of course. As a result of that, you will get angry. Somebody deceive you, you will get angry. Women in special days, they get angry fast. The person with addiction, nasha, they take morana or some kind of addiction, and they don't get that addicted thing. When they use, they get angry. Some people, they make their muscle. Now they feel very strong. When they walk such a way, if anybody hits me, I push him down. So they get angry fast if somebody say they matter thing because they have their muscle. They made their muscle very, very, very strong. And to the weak person, they get angry fast. Fast food has such ingredients which make you angry fast. Such sensitive video games, you, social media, video games, such fighting game, fighting kind of game you see, you will get angry fast. The sick person, he has pain, and somebody bother him. He will get angry fast. If traffic jam, will get angry. The age of 13 to 33, this is the age of getting angry fast. And age of 20th, oh ho, at the height, at the top. Handsome men and beautiful women, they are proud of their beauty and they get angry fast. In short, the women shout a lot on the children and teachers shout over the students who bother them too much. These, what I mentioned before you, the reason, maybe somebody also, you may have faced it, common reason why people get fast anger. Now to the person, how to behave with the anger, this emotion. What are the dangers? What are the nuksanat, disadvantage of having too much anger? What are the harms? Because of anger, divorce happens. The main reason, 80% divorce happens in anger. As they do right away in one shot, talak. These are signs of angry people. Then if the person is a boss, supervisor, and he has this bad disease of anger, then his staff will be upset. He cannot run the office show properly. The person angry, his BP is always high, blood pressure always high. And such person cannot remain happy in the life. He always in a pensive mood. I think I am unlucky. The person who has this disease of anger, he gets heart attack 3 times more than those people who don't have this disease of too much anger. The anger person often gets headache and back pain. And when women become very angry, they do baddua. They make pray against the children. They say, curse on you. And this is very dangerous. Who knows? Sometimes they say, oh, the child is bothering. They say, you die. Dafao ya, mar ja. You die. And maybe the same time, what you say, it is accepted. And child die, then you cry. Woman in the anger, woman threaten normally to the husband. But when men become angry, they don't threaten, but they take action. The woman should be very watchful. As a result of that, too much anger, quarrel happen, fight happen, murder happen. Most of the people who are in the jail, ask them. They will tell you, oh, I was very angry. I don't know where I was, what happened to me. Anger makes your heart dirty. As a result of that, your iman becomes very low. As a result of that, your amal are very not good amal. You do bad amal. If heart is dirty, then iman will become dirty, then amal will become dirty. But do you know that the person who has a disease of kina and bughz, because of that, person become angry in Lailatul Qadr, The person who has a grudge in the heart, his no dua is accepted. Let me tell you frankly. Sometimes the person who is in anger, he acts like an animal. Like a snake, like a scorpion. And even he does not remain in the boundary of the humanity. So, these are few dangers I told you about the anger. Now, what the best anger? What to do then? We have to manage it. We have to control it. Moderate it. The purpose is not to finish the anger. The Ajahn Barkha did not say to finish the anger, but swallow the anger. Allah loves those people who control their anger, swallow their anger. Now, please, self-evaluate yourself that all those asbab, reasons, what I mentioned, do you have those signs? Check yourself. I have those three criteria. Do you become angry fast and remain angry days and days? Do you become angry very late and then keep anger many days? These both are you have disease. But if anger comes to you very late and go away very late, very early, if anger comes to you very late and go away very fast, you are in good condition. Congratulations. Your anger is under your control. You are moderate. You have not this disease, and you will save yourself from a lot of disadvantage and harms of the anger. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to understand the Ayat-e-Mubarakah and Hadith-e-Pak, we mentioned. So Allah will love us. The third party, if you are anger under control, you are Mahbub, beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us if we have diseased anger to control that anger. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our conditions, outer condition, inner condition, very pleasant so we cannot face this kind of disease, anger, and as a result of that, we can save ourselves from lot of nuksanat, lot of dangers, lot of harms. Wa akhir damana, alhamdulillah rabbil alamin, subhana rabbika rabbil izzat amma yasifun, wa salamun ala mursalin, walhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Inshallah, next time, I will tell what is the ilaj, how to control the anger. And also, I give you some examples of our elders, in the past history of Islam, who how they controlled anger. JazakAllah khair shukran. Now, please, this is Corona time, first time, please, read dua behind me, please. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من البرص والجنون والجزام ومن سيء الأسقام. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من البرص والجنون والجزام ومن سيء الأسقام. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من البرص والجنون والجزام ومن سيء الأسقام. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. وصلى الله تعالى على حبيبه سيدنا محمد وآله وأصحابه أجمعين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. إن شاء الله see you again, my respected, my listener, إن شاء الله ناظرين. Inshallah, next Sunday. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.